Well, excellent way to start the session. Nice 31-pound common, fish called the bullet hole. And yeah, I haven't had that fish before. Harley hasn't had it either, so I'm pretty chuffed with that. And I think it's very rarely does over 30, so again, I'm chuffed to have that at 31. So as you probably guessed, well, I'm back on the Syndicate again. Me and Harley just came here for, well, one night last night, and I'm here again for tonight as well. And yeah, we didn't get here till late last night. It was actually dark when we got here, so just managed to get the rods out. Had something to eat, and then I got an early night, and yeah, I wanted to get up nice and early to watch the water for sunrise. And yeah, I sat there and the rod screamed off, so really pleased with that. So yeah, we're at the Syndicate again. Probably gonna be here till tomorrow lunchtime now. So another night for me. Hopefully we'll have another fish. And in this vlog, basically what I'm gonna do on this vlog, this is not gonna be a very long one. I'm just gonna announce the winner of the giveaway that I did on my last vlog for the hook links and leaders. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do that live on this vlog. So basically I'll get my laptop out in a little while, and I'll choose the winner on a comment picker on the laptop, and I'll film it live as I'm doing it. So yeah, I look forward to doing that, and look forward to giving away some of our hook links and leaders. And also gonna talk to you about what I've been up to this month. If you're a member of our Facebook group, you'll know already, but I've got some pretty exciting news to tell you, so I look forward to doing that. So just give you a quick look around the swim. So yeah, I'm in a swim called Sleepers this time. Let's go around the bivvy a minute. Yeah, I'm in a swim called Sleepers. Haven't really fished this swim very much, to be honest, and I don't think I've ever actually had fish out of here. I do know of some spots off here that I found a couple of years ago when I fished this swim. And yeah, nice hard silty spots out there. And that's what I did last night. As soon as I got here, basically just put some Ronnie rigs on. Just put some single pop-ups on, the white tent from Hells, put them on. And then just banged them out to that spot out there, and yeah, produced that fish this morning. So really chuffed with that. But yeah, that was quite a nice morning this morning. The sun was coming up and everything. And yeah, it's gone really overcast now. And we've got a nice wind blowing. I think it's blowing northeasterly at the minute, so it's a little bit chilly. So at least I'm not sitting here in the baking heat, which is nice. There's a few people on, and they did actually have a work party on here a little while ago. We had the lake owner and a couple of the bailiffs were down here, and they were doing a bit of streaming and a bit of tree cutting and that. I think they've got a charity match on here at the weekend, so they're just having a bit of a tidy up for that. So yeah. Hopefully we'll have another fish on the session. Got the Tempest with me now. I like to bring the Tempest with me sometimes, especially with all the camera gear I got and that. It's nice to keep it all nice and clean and safe inside a nice big bivvy. That brolly's all right that I've got, but yeah, it's nice to get the Tempest out every now and again. So, what I'm gonna do now, I think I'm gonna get myself something to eat because I don't have no breakfast yet. After all the excitement of having that fish, so I'm gonna get myself some breakfast. And probably get the rods out again. I'll redo my rods, rebait them, get them back on that spot again. Then I'm probably going to put some bait out. So I'll show you what bait I'm going to be using as well over the top of the rigs. So I'll get back to you in a bit. Well, that's breakfast out of the way now. And yeah, those sausage and bacon baps went down nicely. I was getting a bit hungry there, so that was nice. And yeah, managed to bring the rods in as well, refresh the hook baits. and got the rods back out on the spot again. I've basically put all three rods bang on that spot where I had that coming from this morning now. So yeah, they're about 3 foot apart. So they all went down with a nice donk on a nice hard silty patch. So put them out with the Ronnie rigs. For those of you who've been following my vlogs, you'll know I've been using the multi rig for quite a while. And post lockdown, I haven't really had a lot of success, to be honest. So I thought I'd switch over to the Ronnie rig again, give that another go. And I know Harley's been doing quite well on the Syndicate on the Ronnie rig. So yeah, I thought I'd bang that out there, give that a go. So yeah, my setup's just my usual setup with the chain core leader, with the Nexus chain core leader, with the heli safe on a helicopter setup, and with just a semi-stiff hook link with the Ronnie rig on it. And yeah, that's bagged me that nice common this morning. So hopefully with three of them out there, good chance of another fish. And yeah, just spotted a bit of bait over the top there. Put some of the Atlantic Heat boilie pellets with some Coppins pellets on there out there, mixed up with some hemp, some sweet corn, and some Baitworks boilies. Basically, you've got some of the Royal Marine in there, some of the Atlantic Heat in there, and some Cremino in there, all crushed up, and with a bit of hemp oil over the top as well, just mixed in. So yeah, there's half a bucket of that out there, and I've just spotted that around the general area. So hopefully that'll bring the fish in and keep them in there. Also had a couple of nights on the Syndicate as well. Came down the other week with Harley, and did a little bit of a social down here with Harley in the social swims. And yeah, Harley had a nice little fish. He's been fishing an area that he's been baiting, and yeah, he managed to bag one of the little stockies, little 19-pound stockies. So yeah, that was good. So managed to get a bit of footage of that on the on camera. So yeah, that was a nice little session. And yeah, also on this vlog, what I'm going to do, like I mentioned earlier, I'm going to be announcing the giveaway for the hook links and leaders that I announced on my last vlog. So what I've got here is I've got my laptop here, got another camera. So basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to do this live on this vlog, so I'll do this now. So what I'll do is I'll just switch the other camera on and start recording on that. So there's my website, or my YouTube channel, I should say. So basically what I've got here, I mean, I've used this before when I did a giveaway before for the Baitworks boilies. It's exactly the same comment picker. So it's just basically you put your YouTube URL in there, and basically it picks a random comment of somebody who's put whatever text I asked to put in there. So basically, so this is the video. So that's the video that I did. So basically what I need to do now is copy that URL like so, go back onto the random comment picker, and that URL basically goes in there like so. Hopefully you can see this. So there's the URL for the YouTube video. So now I want to filter duplicate users there. So basically I don't want the same person going in there twice. Include replies to comments, so if anybody's put the right answer in a reply to a comment, that'll come up. And also filter comments based on the graphic, the specific text. So basically what I asked you to say in the comment was our website address. So I put www.acarpyconnection.co.uk. There you go. So all I do now, scroll up there. Now click on here, get YouTube comments. So that's now working to get all the comments that was that had the right answer in. So we've got 66 comments there. So what I do now is go up here. Good luck. And the winner is Mark B Painting. So Mark B Painting, you're the winner of the leaders and the hook links that I mentioned in my last vlog. Well done, mate. Also, I've got some exciting news to tell you. I've worked in manufacturing all my life. I've worked in manufacturing since I was 16 years old in factories, and basically this week or last week, I actually give my notice in at my job that I'm in at the moment. I've been there about 8 or 9 years working in a factory, and in a specific factory near mine, and yeah, managed to get my notice in because I've now got myself a job as a full-time videographer for a fishing tackle company, for quite a big fishing tackle company as well, which I'm very pleased about. I think that's basically through my YouTube channel. I started doing these vlogs just over a year ago now, and I've had a lot of support from people, so I'd just like to thank everybody who's continued to support my YouTube channel, and also on my Facebook group and Instagram and everything as well. There's been quite a few people that have been there right from the beginning who have always given like really nice comments and just followed me all the way through. So I'd like to thank you all for that, and I really appreciate that. And it's due to my YouTube channel that the reason I've got this job, and yeah, it's just basically a dream job really. I'm really into my fishing, really into my videography, so to combine those and turn it into a job has been it's a bit of a dream come true, really. So yeah, I'm really excited about that. I won't actually say who the company is at the moment, but if you're on my Facebook group, you'll know already anyway. But I'll probably announce it next month when I actually start the job full time. So well done, Mark B. Payton, for winning the giveaway. And yeah, that's like I say, that's now starting to slick up there again on my spot. And hopefully we'll be into another fish on this session. So I'm going to kick back now. I might make myself a brew. It's getting quite late in the afternoon now, and it's starting to fog over a little bit as well. So yeah, I'm going to kick back now, have myself a coffee, and I'll get back to you in a bit. Well, nothing to report at the minute really. They're still slicking up out there, but I haven't actually seen any fish showing over the spot, so it could either be silverfish or tench or even the crayfish disturbing the spot out there. So hopefully the fish will move in on that bait that I put out there earlier, and we'll have another fish tonight or in the morning. So I think what I'm gonna do now, I'm gonna shut the bivvy door up and put the cameras away because it's getting dark now and it's getting quite cold. They're still blowing that northeasterly. And yeah, it's quite cold. So what I'm gonna do is put the cameras away. And if I don't see you in the night, I'll see you first thing in the morning. So until then, see you later. Thank you. Well, what a session this is turning out to be. Just had another one. Lovely mirror. Nice apple slice mirror, this one. Let's have a quick look at it. Look at that. Beautiful fish. Never had this one before. This was taken on the Ronnie rig again. Started using the Ronnie rig with a white stem from Hell Pop up on it. And put a little bit of bait out yesterday. Just put some pellet out there, some hemp, a bit of sweet corn, some of the Atlantic Heat boilie pellets, a bit of raw marine, some Atlantic Heat and some creamino all crushed up in there with a little bit of hemp oil. On that same spot I had the common from yesterday. And yeah, like clockwork, first thing in the morning, this went off again. Oh. Beautiful fish. Like I say, I don't think I've ever had this one before out of here. So, checking the fish off the list now. Lovely. Let's have a look at the other side. Quickly. Beautiful apple slice scales on it. I think this usually goes around 27, 28, this does. Look at that. Right, let's get it weighed. Get it back. What a session. Twenty-nine two. Bang on. Right, it's got a few sores on it, so I'll just put some clinic on it. Get a bite. Well, we come to the end of the session now. What a session that turned out to be. And yeah, we only got here quite late on the first night, so that night was discounted, but had a nice bite first thing in the morning. That nice 31 pound common. Yeah, I haven't had that one before, so I'm really chuffed with that. It's a fish called Bullet Hole. And I think it's I said it's top weight as well, I think. I've spun out at 31 before, from what I know. From what Harley reckons, I spun out at 31 last year. So yeah, I'm really chuffed with that. And yeah, that 29 pound two mirror this morning, really pleased with that as well. And I think I actually got the fight on video. I sat there and I thought bite time was coming up, so I thought I'd set the camera up, got it all focused in, and then just switched it off and left it sat there. I was then pouring a coffee out and the rod screamed off, so I managed to get the camera switched on. and hit the bite. And I noticed when I picked the rod up, the fish just shot to the surface and really boshed out on the surface. So hopefully we've got that on camera so you can see that. That'll be good. And yeah, what a confidence boost. I mean, changing to the Ronnie rig, like I said earlier in the vlog, I've been using the multi-rig for quite a while now, and I've had quite a good success on it. But since lockdown, fishing's been a bit crap really, to be honest. I haven't been doing very well. So yeah, I thought I'd try the Ronnie rig. I know Harley's been doing quite well on here with the Ronnie rig. So I thought I'd give that a go. And yeah, it's paid off. So yeah, I think I'll be using that for a little bit longer. Keep using the Ronnie. It's for give me a little nice bit of confidence now with the white scent from Hells. So yeah, that's got me two fish. So yeah, the lake's looking beautiful this morning. It's gone a bit chilly though. And yeah, I think autumn's definitely here now. It's blowing a northeasterly wind, which is right up into that corner now. So, but that spot is actually still slicking up. Once the wind gets on the water, you can actually see it still slicking up. But whether it's carp on it or whether it's just smaller fish on there, or could even be the crays on there disturbing it, to be honest. Or that just could be the where it was disturbed earlier, just keep floating to the surface. So, but yeah, it's about 9 o'clock now. So I've got. Just still got the rods in. All I've got to do is get the rods in. I've got everything else on the barrow now. Everything's packed away apart from the essentials. Still got my kettle out and my coffee. So yeah, I think I'm gonna give it another half an hour. And then yeah, head home. I'm at work tomorrow night. So again, like this is only a short session. I think the next time you see me will be from the new pit I was telling you about earlier, the 100 acre pit. So yeah, we're gonna go and give that a go next week, I think, or the week after. And yeah, I'll probably do some a bit of a vlog from there and put that out. Sorry again, this is only a short one, but I've been really busy lately and I haven't really been able to get out and do lots of filming. So I've been trying to just fish and trying to catch fish at the moment. So trying to get the filming on the side a little bit. And yeah, like my news I told you earlier, really excited about my new job I've got. So I'll probably announce that, who I'm actually working for, in the next vlog. Once it's all official and once I actually start the job. So yeah, that's really exciting news. So if you're new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon, and you'll be notified of any new vlogs that I upload. And also don't forget to go back and check out the other vlogs that I've done as well. And also our Instagram page is doing really well at the minute. We've got 985 followers on there now, so it'd be nice to get to 1,000. So check that, it's at a Carpy Connection. And also our Facebook group as well, which is a Carpy Connection. Don't forget to give that a look and a follow, and come on in there and say hi. Some pretty good people on there. We have a bit of banter on there. So yeah, don't forget to come and check that out. So yeah, I think what I'm gonna do now, like I said, just get the rods and everything away and then get myself home. So they've got a match on here the weekend. So they've got a charity match, which they have once a year. So I expect there'll be plenty of bait going in. So yeah, I'll be glad to be able to steer clear of this place for the weekend, I think. And probably come back in a few weeks' time. Also Redhouse as well, I'll try and get back on there too soon and give that another go. So yeah, plenty to do. So hope you enjoyed this vlog. And until next time, be lucky.